How's it going, guys? This is the Core 3 from findinggamesonline.info, and today we're going to be going over installation tutorial and setting up tutorial for Demul. For those who are not familiar with Demul, it is a Dreamcast emulator, and it's been out for some time. And I guess like what's important to note about it is that it is playable online, and so you can play a lot of the fighting game titles that were available for arcade as well as Dreamcast. But today we're primarily going to focus on games that are going to be playable online. So let's go ahead and get started. Now, you should have already downloaded the pack that I provided. There's also a link below in the description for those who are interested. You will need some sort of unpack or unzip program in order to set up this file. So I recommend using WinRAR. You can just Google it and find it, but you're going to need that in order to be able to unzip this. Okay, so let's go ahead and start. So I'm gonna go ahead and extract this to the desktop, and we'll just name it for right now. Actually, we don't even have to name it, so we're just gonna extract it to the desktop. Okay. And once you're done that, you should see the folder for it. Now there's a couple things I just want to go over real quick before we get into setting up the Demul. Just a couple of files. The most important one, of course, is the Demul.exe file, which is how you're going to run the program. The next thing, of course, you want to look at is the ROMs folder. And the ROMs folder is basically where you're going to be putting your games so that you can play them. Other folders that are kind of important to note are like the plugins folder. That's only if you, in fact, plan to add some plugins. And I think that's pretty much it. Another thing I wanted to note was, of course, what is going to allow us to play online, which is the Calera client, which is this right here. In order for this to run properly, you had to have both Calera client on the outside of the folder and on the inside of the plugin folder. The Calera client is something that you can basically download, and there's been different variations of it. Different people have kind of modified it, and we also have a modified version of the Calera client that we're going to show today. But just in case, anytime if you really wanted to switch out the Calera client, this is something that you have to do in order to get it to run properly. So you have to have both the Calera client on the outside here, and you also have to have it in the plugin folder. So I just wanted to make a note of that. All right, so once that's finished, we're ready to go ahead and start to set up what's needed in order to run the program. Okay, so the first thing that we want to do is go into config, and we're going to go ahead and go into plugins. Okay, so for me, when you have gotten this, you're probably going to see this in your plugins and your you know, these directories, but you have to basically reset these directories in order for your plugins to show up. And I'm going to show you kind of, you know, I'm going to go into desktop, of course, and then I'm going to go into my repack, and I'm going to go look for plugins, because right now that's what we're looking for. I'm going to hit plugins, And what you'll notice, as soon as I go into locate the plugins folder, you're gonna see all these options come up here for me to choose from. Okay. So let's, before we get into the options, let's go ahead and continue here. As you can see, I've already gotten my ROMs folder set up. So the only thing that's left to do is the BIOS, which is the NVRAM, I believe. Okay. Now, let me just make a quick note of that. Yeah. Okay, so that's not really what we're looking for, but yeah. So let me just, I kind of skipped over something. Just to be clear, the other thing that you want to put in your ROMs folder are the BIOS. And I'm going to kind of get into that a little bit later, but I just kind of wanted to go over that really quick. Okay, so let's go back to our settings. So I'm going back to plugins. And now we're going to go ahead and just start to set up certain plugins. This will be pretty quick. Up here, you're going to want to go to the GPU DVX3 plugin. Okay, it will work on a legacy, but I believe that that might cause some problems. So you're going to want to run the video plugin on GPU DXV3. Now, the other thing you want to make sure that you have here is that the GDROM plugin is GDRCHD. That's going to be where most of your ROM files are going to be playing on. Okay, but there's also other things. If you have like images from your Dreamcast, those would be GDR image. Okay, the next thing you want to make sure you have is your Netplay plugin. On the right thing, you have two choices here, which is the Net Demul Null and Netblade. So you want to pick Netblade for your ROM choice for your plug, your Netplay plugin. Okay, and then you're gonna hit OK. Yeah, so we should be fine here. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and actually get into setting up to play for the game. Oh, one more thing before we get up into setting up to play for the game. We're going to go ahead and go into controller. So you're going to go to your gamepad, and then you're going to go to Joy 1. Now, it's very important to note that there are three different configurations here, and just one global configuration here. Okay, yeah, you're going to keep D input here as your select device API. But what's important to note is that these three are different setups, and I'm going to get into that in just a few minutes. But for right now, we're going to focus on this one here, which is JAMA. And of course, you're going to come in here and you're going to set your controls in here. Okay, so you do want to do that for all three just in case. And I'm going to show you why that is important. And hit OK. All right, so now we're ready to go ahead and run the game. We've set up all our controls. We've basically put the locations for each of the plugins in the ROMs, and we're ready to go ahead and start playing. So then you're just going to go ahead and go over to file, and so we're going to just go ahead and get into the quick explanation of how you're going to end up running your game ROMs. Now you have three different three different options to run your games from. The first you see is Run DC, second is Run Naomi, and then third is Run Atomic Wave. Now you noticed previously when I was showing you how to configure your game pads that you saw those three options, and this is the reason is because your games can run on three different hardwares, okay? So the first one, which is says DC, is basically the DC is Dreamcast, the console version, okay? So if you want to run any console version, that's going to be running through Dreamcast, and that's going to be basically mostly image files, I believe, that run through the Dreamcast. Your second option is the Naomi, right? And what Naomi is basically the arcade board that ran a lot of the Dreamcast games. So it runs certain games, like of course the most popular game that it runs is Capcom vs. SNK 2. It also runs Marvel vs. Capcom 2. So those are the ones that Naomi runs. And then you also have Atomus Wave, that runs some games like Hokuto no Ken and King of Fighters 11, I believe. What's also important to note about these three options is that in order to play the games, you're going to need the BIOS for all three of those options. Okay, so if you want to run Atomus Wave, you have to have Atomus Wave BIOS right now. And then if you want to run Naomi, you know, so you have to make sure that you have the BIOS for all three of those in order to run the game. So what we're going to go ahead and do is we're going to run the Capcom versus SNK2 game, which happens to be in Naomi. Okay. So we're just going to scroll down here, and as you can see, they basically have all the titles that run on this this board available here, so you have an idea of what is available for running. All right. So now I'm coming down here to Capcom versus SNK2. All right. And you can see what the name is. And then you're just going to hit OK. It might take a little bit to run, so depending on what your computer runs like. Okay. And once you do that, it's basically going to bring up the Calera client. Okay. So this is what we're looking at right now. This is what's going to allow us to connect to play somebody online. At the moment, the only mode that this client carries is P2P, which is person to person. So basically, you have two types. You have P2P and you have server. Okay, and server kind of allows you to connect to a server where there's a bunch of people that you can play against. But P2P is more direct, where you actually have to get somebody's IP address, or you get their IP address, and you know, you connect to each other and play directly, which I think is the more recommended thing to do. So let's basically give you a scenario for both hosting and also for connecting to. Okay, so if you're the host, this basically means that you're going to be giving somebody your IP address in order for them to come and play with you. So that means basically that you're inviting them to come play on your connection. If you're not familiar with IP address, that's basically your personal address, or you know, of where you're located. What you can do if you need the IP address is you can go to speedtest.net, or I believe you can go to pingtest.net. Okay, I will put the correct web information when I'm redoing the video, but there you can get your IP address, because I believe the options that they have here, you won't be able to. So let's say that you're going to go ahead and allow somebody, you know, give somebody your IP address. It's very important to note that, you know, when you give your IP address to somebody, it's somebody that you should trust. You don't want to just give your IP address to anybody. So this is somebody that you trust. And once you do that, you go ahead and hit host. Okay. And what will happen is, when somebody connects to you, they're going to automatically come up in this window, and they'll have their name, and then of course all you have to do is come here and just say click here when ready, and then that's going to start the game up. Okay, now okay, so if you're on the other end and you're going to connect to somebody, this means that you now have to get the person's IP address. So what you're going to do is, if you're the person that is connecting to the host, is you're going to put in their IP address. I'm just going to make up an IP address here, you know. Just making up one, just out of my head. And then you're just going to hit connect. Okay. And, you know, if everything goes okay, you should be able to connect to them and go ahead and start the game. And you can also come here and you can store their IP address here for your own, you know, for your own ease, of course. Okay. So once you've done that, the game will basically start up, and essentially it'll run just like you're playing it at the arcade. You know, as long as you have all your buttons configured correctly and you have your start button configured correctly, everything should run pretty smoothly, and you should be able to start playing. So if you decide that you don't really want to play online, the easiest thing you can do is just go ahead and come out of here, and the game is going to run. And there's another reason that I wanted to run the game really quick. It's just to show you the most important part, which is you're going to want to run the game before you actually go online. And the reason you want to do that is because you want to make sure that your game is running at 60 FPS. Okay. And how you can tell if your game is running at this speed is you can look up here and you're going to see that this is like running around about 60. Sometimes it does go down, sometimes it does go up, but for the most part it's able to maintain about 60 frames per second. So that's very important when you're trying to run this game. If you cannot run this game at 60 frames per second, that means that you're probably not going to be able to play online with this game, and it's not going to run properly. Okay, so that's pretty much it for the tutorial. Hopefully this information is helpful for you. We'll be putting up another tutorial for 5.7, and basically you can go ahead and look in your description and you'll find a download for this pack. All right, take it easy and have fun.